BBC Audio presents James Acaster's Findings, where the comedian presents the results of his in-depth research into a variety of subjects.
Hello, James Acaster here. I'm one of the leading researchers working in the United Kingdom today. I'm also a massive fan of bread. In fact, I love it so much, I spent the last week of my life doing research into the subject. I'd like to share my findings with you tonight. First thing I did was I bought a bread bin. This took some getting used to, actually. The main thing that's difficult to remember when you buy a bread bin is to put it out on Wednesday. Bread. The other piece of kit I needed was a bread knife, which I discovered can cut other things besides bread. A true story. Much like the teaspoon, which, as well as tea bags, can be used on boiled eggs and yoghurt. Also, a teaspoon isn't the only thing you can make a cup of tea with. Sometimes, all my teaspoons are dirty. On several occasions, I have made a cup of tea with a fork, transforming it into a tea fork. You can also make a cup of tea with a knife, a tea knife, once you've mastered the lever and lift technique. You can't make a cup of tea with a bread knife, though. It's too big. And the jagged blade will risk perforating the bag. So it does have some limits. In the studio with me today is my fantastic assistant, Nathaniel Metcalfe.
Hello.
I actually once visited Nathaniel to find him making a cup of tea with a pair of chopsticks.
Yeah.
It sounds impressive, but he was doing it two-handed. picking up the tea bag with a chopstick in each hand.
Yeah, I had to walk to the bin like a crab.
The only thing worse, when I visited him 3 months later, he was making a cup of tea with a chopstick. And the other one weren't even waiting to be washed up either. Tell them where it was.
It was wedged in the upstairs window to stop it from rattling.
What a legend. There's no such thing as prawn bread. So the origin of prawn toast remains a mystery. Brioche. Brioche is a sweet French bread. Its packaging often bears the slogan tear and share, which in French is
déchirer et partager,
which is not as catchy because it doesn't rhyme. Very unlucky for everyone in France. The French have taken a lot of stick from the British over the years, but this must really wind them up. It's their own bread. We're having a better time with it. And the French love poetry. To make matters worse, there's no combination of words that can give them the rhyme they so desperately crave. I know, I've researched it.
Séparer et passer.
Separate and pass.
Couper et de désigner.
Sever and designate.
Lacérer et de donner.
Lacerate and give.
Déchiqueter. Et répartir entre.
Shred and divide among.
Mangez la brioche avec vos amis.
Eat brioche with your friends. I don't know why we stopped at brioche, to be honest. I think we can have even more fun making rhymes about everything the French hold dear. So I've been working on some slogans of my own. For example, with butter and jam, there's no better. Remember to brush all the flakes off your sweater.
The croissant.
Of English he knows every word of. He's the only French actor I've heard of.
Gérard Depardieu.
Now, I don't want this to come across as French bashing, because, you know, I think the French are brilliant. They just can't rhyme. Frère Jacques, probably the most famous and highly respected French poem of all time. Nathaniel.
Yeah?
Read that thing I gave you.
Frère Jacques,
Frère
Jacques, dormez-vous.
You've not got a natural singing voice.
Dormez-vous.
Don't bother.
Sonne le matin.
All over the shop with your pitching.
Sonne le matin.
Talked about. Din, dan, okay, fine.
Din, dan, don.
See? They have to repeat every line twice because the only word they can think of that rhymes with a word. The exact same word.
Hey guys, what rhymes with sonne le matin?
Sonne le matin?
Anything else rhyme with sonne le matin?
Probably, but I doubt it rhymes as well as sonne le matin does. Like, every single part of Sonne Le Mattina rhymes perfectly with every single part of Sonne Le Mattina. Same goes for Faire Jacques, Dormez-vous, and Din Dan Dot. I just saved us half a day's work.
If we just rhymed words with themselves, then the slogan for brioche would be tear and tear. And that's tragic. No more sharing, no more coming together. We lose contact with all our loved ones, all because we were too lazy to come up with a decent rhyme. You know the seeds on top of a bread roll? They're not for flavour. They're for grip. When's the last time you dropped a bread roll? Exactly. Croutons. Croutons were originally named buoyant soup cubes, but were eventually renamed croutons after their inventor, Jim Crouton, who ironically drowned. Croutons were exclusively used in soup until Julius Caesar added them to his world-famous salad. Of course, Mr. Caesar was stabbed to death by Brutus. So, as you can see, everyone associated with the crouton has died.
Messed up.
Bagels. Bagel is Yiddish for trendy sandwich. But why is it so trendy? Before the bagel, sandwiches came in two shapes, rectangles and triangles. Now, thanks to the bagel, we can have a rectangular sandwich, a triangular sandwich, or a circular sandwich with a hole in the middle. A hole. We never thought to put a hole in a sandwich before, because we previously wanted to keep the filling inside. In fact, no one has ever before thought to put an open hole in anything they don't want things falling out of. Historically, holes are exactly what you don't want when trying to contain something. They are usually avoided at all costs, and people go to great lengths to prevent them. They don't deliberately install them. Obvious exception to the rule, the bath and sink. But they have holes in them for a reason. And they also provide a plug so you can eliminate the hole when necessary. I have written to the bagel companies suggesting the introduction of a bread plug. But they're yet to get back to me, so in the meantime, I have to thread the bagel onto a baguette or untoasted panini. This gets rid of the hole and also provides you with a handle if you wish to hold the baguette and eat the bagel like an ice cream. Or you can position the bagel in the middle of the baguette and then hold the baguette horizontally with a hand at each end, eating the bagel like a corn on the cob and turning as you go. Even the donut, the bagel's sweet cousin, either has a hole or a filling. It never has both, because that'd be impractical. But then again, donuts aren't eaten by the trendy kids. They're eaten by the police, who are not cool, because they're always going around stopping all the cool crimes from happening. Like joyriding and streaking. So I wanted to know why the bagel had a hole in it. Turns out, it's so it bakes evenly all the way through. Same goes for donuts and the Polo Mint. Bit of a cheat, though, isn't it? They basically just removed the difficult bit that usually cooks last. Like, most of the food I've ever made has been cooked evenly all the way through, providing you don't count the middle. Well, that's always the worry when cooking.
Is it cooked in the middle?
Not sure. Let's poke it with a knife.
But in the bagel's case...
Is it cooked in the middle?
There is no middle.
Then let's eat.
13 out of 12 people don't know what a baker's dozen is. Challenge. One of the challenges I set myself this week was to memorise the shape of every single bread product so I could recognise them on sight, by feel, or simply by description. I wanted to test my abilities tonight.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.